Hello everybody. Last class we are discussing about the ideal solution. Now this time we will try to look into the regular solution and what may be the interpretation of the regular solution in terms of the different thermodynamic parameters. So the formation of the solid solution is actually either endothermic or exothermic most of the cases. So therefore, in that case the enthalpy of mixing might be having some finite values, but in the model of the ideal solution we neglected this in the form of either endothermic or exothermic reaction. And here in that case we assume that delta H mix was 0, but in quasi chemical model the heat of mixing can be represented or can be explained just by looking into the bond energies between the atoms, adjacent atoms. But before that we need to know that what may be the way, what are the different ways the atoms can be configured such that roughly you can estimate the bond energy associated with the specific configuration of the atoms. Now if the volumes of pure A, for example, we are mixing in binary solution atom A and B, the volumes of pure A and pure B, they are equal and not change during the mixing. So therefore, after mixing or during the mixing there is no change in the volume in the solution. So in that case the interatomic distance and bond energies, we can consider these are the independent of the composition of the. This is a very specific case when we can understand that if pure A and B are mixing, but in very ideal situation that during the mixing the interatomic distance and bond energies, we can assume these are the independent of the composition if there is no change in the volume during mixing. With this we can see that ordinary solution following the arrangement of the atoms we are considering, for example, bond energy between A and A atom. So epsilon AA, bond energy between BB atoms, epsilon BB, and bond energy between A and B atoms, epsilon AB. And the figure shows that these are the specific arrangement of the atoms in the solid solution, so that they are connected AA, it might be connected, the several probabilities of connection is possible here between AA, between BB, or between AB. These are the three ways the atoms can be configured or they are connected, and based on that we can estimate the bond energy. Now the internal energy of the system simply representation in terms of the only the bond energy between the atoms. So here E equal to P A epsilon A, epsilon A is the bond energy between atoms A, between two A atoms, and P B is the P, capital P indicates the number of bonds. So number of bonds, and epsilon A A, it indicates the bond energy associated with this particular bond. So you can simply calculate, this is the representation of the total internal energy of the system. So therefore we have this comment PA, PB, number of bonds between the atoms BB and number of bonds between atoms A and B. So this way we can simply calculate the total energy. I think it should be PAB, not PB exactly, it should be PAB, number of bonds between atom A and B. Now before mixing pure A and pure B contains only AA and BB bond. So just before mixing all A atoms are there, so bonding is possibility between AA atoms, and in the similar way the bonding for the B atoms, the bonding between the B atoms was possible. Now after mixing the change in the internal energy on mixing is simply expressed by the enthalpy of mixing delta H mix. So that is the PAB into epsilon, epsilon is the bond energy, effective values of the bond energy. So now there are different expression in this particular ideal situation. This epsilon bond energy can be represented is like that, epsilon AB between A and B minus half of epsilon AA plus epsilon BB. So this is the, this indicates the difference between the bond energy, and we can estimate that the enthalpy of mixing is equivalent to the bond energy of mixing. Now here this is a rough estimate that epsilon AB bond energy between A and B, but since two atoms AA can create one bond and atoms BB can be bond, and other atoms are utilize the bonding between the A and B atom. That's why we have configured half of epsilon AA plus epsilon BB. Now, if epsilon equal to 0, for example, in this case epsilon equal to 0, and that indicates the enthalpy of mixing also equal to 0. It means the solution is ideal. So, that was the assumptions in case of the ideal solution, where the atoms are completely randomly arranged and the entropy of mixing is expressed like that, delta S mix equal to R into X A ln logarithm of X A plus X B logarithm of X B. So, this this expression we have already derived and we have already discussed. This is for the ideal solution, but in that case, since we are assuming here epsilon equal to 0, the bond energy is equal to 0, in that case where the atoms are completely randomly arranged. So, that is why this is the with this situation we are assuming the total bond energy equal to effective bond energy equal to 0. It means that enthalpy of mixing equal to 0, and that is true for the ideal solution. And the corresponding delta S mix with this, that is also the expression also we have already derived in case of the ideal solution. Now, in such a solution, it can also be shown that is also possible to calculate that what is the number of bonds between atoms A and B. Roughly you can calculate that N A into Z, N is the Avogadro's number, the number of atoms, Avogadro's number, and that is basically number of atoms per unit mole, Z equal to is the number of bonds per atom, and X A X B, the this is the fraction of atoms A and fraction present in the solution. So, therefore, this is sample calculation PAB indicates the number of bonds per mole, and this is we can utilize this calculation what is the total number of bonds between atoms A and B further. Now, if the situation might be like that epsilon less than 0, epsilon less than 0 means the atoms in the solution will prefer be surrounded by the atoms of the opposite type, and of course will increase the number of AB bonds. So, this is the indication of epsilon equal to 0, because the solution can be endothermic or exothermic. So, heat can be absorbed or heat can be released during the solution, or maybe I can say that during the mixing, and that is the represented by the enthalpy of mixing. Now, if epsilon less than 0, in that case the PAB number of bonds between atoms A and B will increase. Otherwise, if epsilon greater than 0, PAB will tend to be very less than in a random solution. So, tend to be very less means in random solution, that means its effective bonds energy is basically neutralized. So, total effective bond energy will reduce, or in the other way, the number of bonds between atoms A and B will be reduced, will be less in or close to 0 and associated with the random solution. Now, these are the two in these two cases, but epsilon is not too different from the 0. If epsilon greater than 0, PAB will be very close to 0, then epsilon is very close to 0 value. So, therefore, it is very good approximation. So, that means we can approximate that PAB is equal to this expression. That expression we have already discussed, that PAB equal to NAZ, that is the total number of bonds between A and B, such that delta H mix in a solution can be represented like that PAB into epsilon, and PAB into epsilon, and that we can see that we can introduce the omega also here. Omega, that is omega is basically NAZ, epsilon is equivalent to omega, and omega into XA and XP. This is another parameter. So, therefore, this real solution that closely obey the above equation is known as the regular solution. So, that approximate value is not exactly 0 value. So, having some values of the during the mixing, roughly you can estimate the enthalpy of mixing just looking into the what is the bonding number of bonds between atoms A and B. So, this expression is roughly valid if it is closely obey the equation, and this equation is not, this equation not the ideal solution, rather we can say as a regular solution. So, therefore, if we try to estimate the variation of the in regular solution, variation of delta H mix with the composition. So, this is the composition composition 100% A here, 100% B, and AXP is gradually increasing along the x-axis. So, here this curve indicates the delta H mix per mole during the solution, and this is the expression indicates that it is parabolic in nature. Now, figure shows that at omega greater than 0 and the tangents at x A equal to 0. Here you can draw the tangent, it is a cross in this particular value along the B axis, and this value indicates the that range from here to here that actually equivalent to the values of the omega. So, therefore, and this is at x A equal to 0 if you draw the tangent, and even other way x A x A equal to 0 here, the fraction equal to 0 at this point, you make a tangent here, or x A equal to 1 here, you can here also x A equal to at this point x A equal to 1. So, 100% atoms A equal to 1, we can draw the tangent and it cross this value. This actually indicates the omega value, and that omega value here x A equal to 0 at this point. So, from the figure we can say we can define that the plot of the delta H mix, which is parabolic in nature and as a function of the composition, and that is true in case of the regular solution, but it is a regular solution means it is a all we are composition we are talking about, therefore, it is associated with only the binary solution. Now, further binary solution, and but it is a regular solution, in that case the free energy change on mixing a regular solution can be expressed like that. This is the associated with the bond energy, that means we take care of the delta H mix, because we know delta G mix the Gibbs free energy change during the mixing or during making the solution between atoms A and B. So, it is just delta H mix minus T delta S mix. So, we need the what is the enthalpy change, what is the entropy change, and delta H mix equal to omega x A x B, that expression we have already seen, and delta S mix equal to minus R into x L ln A, this expression we have already familiar with this expression. Now, sum of this we are getting delta G mix for the regular solution is that omega x A x B and R T x A ln x A and R T x A ln x A and x B ln x B. So, these are the expression for the delta J mix for the regular solution. Now, if I ask you if what can be the expression delta J mix for the ideal solution, then we can neglect this part, and that is neglect this part, and remaining this corresponds to the ideal solution. So, difference here in this case regular solution and ideal solution, we are making differences in terms of the enthalpy of mixing, and roughly you can estimate the enthalpy of mixing that just looking into the bond energy between the atoms. So, therefore, now we have plot these values of delta G, plotting this thing that delta G mix, delta H mix along with the composition in case of binary solution. So, here 2-4 different cases we can see. One is case is the omega less than 0. So, bond energy or maybe enthalpy of mixing, whether it is positive or negative, that means the enthalpy of mixing, because in case of the exothermic solution delta H mix less than 0. So, therefore, when delta H mix less than 0, it means the omega less than 0, and also it is a both the this exponent delta G mix is the depends more both on the free energy change at different values of the omega and temperature T. So, when delta H mix less than 0, that means omega less than 0, and at high temperature we can see that greater curvature of delta G mix we can observe, okay, and this indicates the delta H mix, and this indicates the minus T delta X mix, but adding to this we are getting delta G mix is at very high temperature. Similarly, at omega less than 0, but or maybe we can say the exothermic solution, but at the same time at low temperature the curvature will be less, you have got delta G mix, and this is coming from delta H mix and T delta X mix, and this is indicates the delta G mix, the curvature is actually low. So, that is the comparison between low temperature and high temperature when in case of the exothermic solution delta H mix less than 0. Now, if it is the endothermic solution when delta H mix greater than 0, then we can see that delta H, it is a greater than 0, this means this is positive delta H mix, but the entropy will be negative, the T delta X mix equal to that part will be negative, the other part of the contribution to the Gibbs free energy change. So, overall effective positive delta H mix and this negative quantity, the effective values of the delta G will be like that, and that is true in case of the high temperature. So, high temperature also we are getting the in this case the high temperature we are getting the delta G mix can be less than 0, that means delta G mix will be 0, and then we can from here we can find out the minimum values of the delta G mix. Now, here also you can see that high temperature T delta X mix, the entropy greater than delta H mix for all compositions, and free energy curve has a positive curvature at all points. At high temperature you can see the free energy curve at the here all the points, the positive curvature at all the points, we are getting the positive curvature at all the points, but in this case here the contribution for the T, that means T delta X mix greater than delta H mix, then only we are getting the positive curvature. But other cases, although endothermic reaction greater than 0, delta H mix greater than 0, but possibility is that delta this can be less than T delta S mix can be less than delta H mix. So, therefore, in that case the it is not necessary that it can have the always the positive curvature, the curvature is changing basically delta G mix. Here the positive quantity but negative quantity, the effective values can be positive or may develop, can develop a negative curvature in the middle. Basically we can see the negative here, the curvature is actually changing in case of the delta G mix. So, that kind of the possibility, but this is valid at case of the in case of the very low temperature, and very high temperature we can see if this condition satisfied then we are getting always the positive curvature, Gibbs free energy. So, we mean to say that and other we can say that Gibbs free energy is negative in certain composition and Gibbs energy can be positive in some other composition, though it may not create any kind of the stable structure, stable solution in this particular case. Now, to some extent in case of the regular solution, if it is possible we can do the differentiation of delta S mix in that case with respect to the composition, then at very low values the xa or xb, that means close to this close to the this thing xxb tends to 0, that means close to this point or close this particular point, the minus t delta x curve becomes vertical infinity, the slope can go to the infinity. So, that is obvious from the differentiation of this particular expression here. So, the slope can be at this point or at this point can go to infinity. So, whereas the slope of delta H mix tends to the some finite value, and that is finite value of omega. So, delta H mix can have some finite value omega, and other cases the slope can be vertical, it means the this vertical and slope can be something in between. So, therefore, with these cases except absolute 0 temperature delta G values is always decrease, on addition of a small amount of the solute. So, that means on addition of the small amount of the solute close to here, that means x a tends to 0, we can say not exactly 0, but tends to 0 means in addition of the small amount of the solute at this particular point, if we compare these two slope, this first this part the between these two. So, one is the can be vertical and another is something less than that. So, therefore, effective values of these two can have delta G mix should have always decrease on addition of the small amount of the solute. So, therefore, the actual free energy of the alloy is expressed like that, G2 can be different way, we can express the G2 equal to the Gibbs free energy at state 2 is equal to the G1 plus delta G, that is initially the state 1, and this is a delta G mix is the Gibbs free energy change due to the mixing or making the solution. So, therefore, G can be expressed in the other way also, G can be G1 XAGA plus XBGB. And delta G mix can be like that state 1, because this is before mixing that part state 1, and delta G this is for the effect of the enthalpy, and this is the effect of the entropy change. So entropy change, this comp, and then here we can see that xAxB further expressed like that, xAxB equal to equivalent to the xAxB into 1, because xA plus xB equal to 1. So that 1 equal to, we can say that xA plus xB can make this expression. Now taking this effect GA, this thing, and here x, this can also be expressed that xA into xB square mean 1 minus xA square, because xA plus xB equal to 1 always. Now we can segregate the effect of the GA in terms of the xA part and the xB part. Then we can compare, we can further write that this is the, we know this xGA equal to mu A xA and mu B xB. So therefore, if we compare for the regular solution, this mu A, if we compare between this expression of G, this and expression of this G, and then this mu A can be expressed like that, GA plus omega into 1 minus x square RT ln xA GB omega into 1 minus xB square RT into ln xB. So this is the similar way, what way we if you remember in case of the ideal solution, we have tried to explain in case of the ideal solution. Here we can see that for ideal solution, the mu A equal to GA plus RT ln xA and mu B equal to GA plus GB plus RT ln xB, that is the chemical partition in case of the ideal solution. Now in case of the regular solution, this expression are little different, where here we can introduce the effect of the omega, and here also introduce effect of the omega, and the different way we can represent the mu A and mu B, that means the chemical potential of a regular solution is these two, by these two expression. So therefore, we can see that in this figure, we can see the different way also, that rather than that two different term enthalpy and entropy component, we are comparing and we are trying to predict the Gibbs free energy for A and B, terms A and B. Rather, we can express the different way also, that is called the activity. So this is the mu A and mu B is the activity, chemical potential, the expression, but this we can make as a single component, such that we represent the similar kind of the expression mu A GA into R ln this one. So this one is equivalent to this particular component. So similarly, this is equivalent to this particular component, and this is called as the small a is the activity, or the different form of the XA and XB, and that is indicated by the activity and relation between them vary with the composition of the solution. Definitely relation will vary with the composition of the solution, because A, this is equivalent to here basically RT ln AA is equal to omega 1 minus XA square plus RT ln XA. So this way, these are the equivalent. So therefore, accordingly AA can have some value or some expression in terms of the other parameters. So that here a small a is known as the activity of the solution. So this is a better way we can represent the activity of the solution, and that is more realistic, because this you are representing in case of the regular solution. So therefore, in the figure, distances AC and BD is expressed here. So we can say the similar way 0, 1 mu A here, and this value RT minus RT ln A, and here also RT ln B, sigma A and sigma B, or I can say like that, it is a either we can get the sigma A and sigma B, or AAAB, both correct, either you can write sigma A sigma B or AAAB. So I can say that sigma A and sigma B here. Okay. So these are different form of the X and XB, and relation between them vary with respect to the composition of the solution. Here basically we can introduce the similar expression of the chemical potential, but for the ideal solution, but in case of the any other solution in terms of the activity of the component A, I think activity of a component A, or here we can write either A or sigma. Now here these are the expressions, so therefore GA, GB is there, and this indicates the delta GA max, but all this in terms of the activity this thing, but here we can represent the mu A. We are relating the mu A in terms of the activity and GB in terms of the activity, that expression we can find out here. Now here you can see that how they are related for the regular solution, this activity A and activity A in terms of the omega and xA, and activity for B or in terms of the omega and xB. So these are the relation we can see that. So for a regular solution, so now assume the pure A and pure B, they have the same crystal structure, and therefore line 1 actually indicates here is the AA, that means activity for B, and here is the XB, representing here AB is representing. Similarly, XA and AA. So one axis the activity, another axis the X, that composition of the atoms A and B. So if we assume the pure A and pure B have the same crystal structure, then the line 1 is basically, this is the indication of the ideal solution. So in case of the ideal solution is basically the activity A is equal to XA and AB equal to XB, and that is true in case of the ideal solution, and representing here in the straight line between these two, 0 to 1. So that is the this, so at any point the XA equal to this, the activity A and XA. So now if delta H mix less than 0, the activity of the components in the solution will be less in an ideal solution, that is the representation of the line 2. So if delta H less than mix, the enthalpy less than 0, therefore the activity of the components in the solution will be the less with as compared to the ideal solution, and vice versa also possibly if delta H mix, the enthalpy of mixing is greater than 0, that is represented by the line 1. So further that, so therefore we can define the activity coefficient gamma A is the ratio of AA by XA for the dilute solution of B in A. So in the dilute solution of B in A means the XB always tends to 0, that means very close to 0, the that means XB is the maximum will be the A in case of the dilute solution. So in that case gamma B can be represented like the AB by XB, and this is more or less constant, and that is predicted by the Henry's law. And other way, gamma B if AA XB is equal to 1 in this case, and that is called the Raoult's law. So therefore this equation can be applied for the dilute solution, all this equation can be applied for the in case of the dilute solution. Basically we are close to here at this particular point, because here the XB tends to 0 in case of the dilute solution, whether we can dilute solution with the solution enriched with atoms A, and here gamma A activity is ratio is there, this is the ratio activity of the coefficient here, and gamma B is the ratio of this thing A and AB into XB activity, the activity coefficient this close to that point, the where the percentage of B is much more, so that is called the, that is close to 1. But within this, when the dilute solution, that Henry's law says that gamma B can be AA and AB, and that is the more or less constant, and but this constant value is defined by the Reynolds law, and that is called the gamma B AB by XP. So these equations, all these equations can be applicable in case of the dilute solution. Now overall you can see that the activity of a component is basically the another means of the describing the state of the component in a solution, like chemical potential. So it is more or less what we have tried to explain the chemical potential, but activity is the another way the describing the particular state of the component, and this case chemical potential is more likely to understandable in case of the ideal solution, but activity is general and that is associated with the regular solution. Now activity and chemical potential are simply basically measure of the tendency of the atom to leave a solution. So that actually indicates, if you remember, when you trying to calculate the chemical potential of an atom. So we are always looking into the one atom is basically added to the solution, and what is the change of the Gibbs free energy. Based on that, we have calculated what is the activity, what is the chemical potential of this particular solution. So simply, it's a measure of the tendency, the tendency of the atom to leave a particular solution, and both are having the philosophically both are similar, the whether activity and chemical potential of a solution. So now, if the activity or chemical potential is low, in that means that atoms are reluctant to leave the solution. So it is the meaning of these things, the activity is very low or chemical potential is low, it means that atoms are reluctant to leave the particular solution. Now, the activity or chemical potential of a component is important when the several condensed phases are in equilibrium. So many phases are in equilibrium, then there is a point to discuss or to know, to understand the activity or chemical potential of this particular solution. So that actually we can see that one particular element, whether it is about to leave from the solution, how is it can leave from the solution or not. So these are the typical understanding of the chemical potential or activity of a regular solution. Okay. That's all, and just this is the end of the one part of this thermodynamic principle and associated with the solidification processing. So now we'll start in the next part of the thermodynamic principle. Thank you very much.